I have a sneaking suspicion that my ISP just cannot handle peak hours, and so that I may just have to stream earlier if, like, anybody even watches earlier. I mean, I just started and we've got 4 people, so it's not too horrible, but, I don't know. It seems like every time I stream at night lately, it has problems. And then I play the exact same crap earlier in the day, and it works fine. Medicom claims they looked at the- and they resolved the issue, but they- nobody let them in, so... and they never called, so I really doubt that they actually did anything. I'm so not used to this pink plorts actually not being complete garbage thing. It's very confusing and strange to me. Also, this place is gonna be frame drop city after I put 50 frickin' pink rad slimes, but whatever. Huh? Oh, chickadoo! Get out of here. I do really wish this game used more than one processor core for physics and stuff. Yeah, I was gonna play some Slime Rancher anyway, and I figured I wanted to test the stream anyway, so I'm pretty sure I'm gonna have to move the stream early too, at least for now. The problem is that on weekdays I can't stream early. Oops. My objective is to get a bunch of... basically just build a bunch of extractor crap and build whatever I can build with all of the crap I get. Feed you some rad plorts. Aren't they freaking creepy? The pink rad ones look creepy to me. I think it's the eyes. But I don't know, the eyes are less creepy with the normal rad slimes. I don't know. Alright, I need more food for you idiots. Ah, get the geometry, please! I really hope they fix this wall. This exact wall I always get stuck on. So we have almost all of what is this one material we're missing? I wonder if that's why I haven't unlocked the last set of upgrades or something. If there are more upgrades. Nothing in here. Nope. I still don't have the treasure pod either, but I don't know if I'm gonna be able to deal with get that anytime soon. The pink plorts being useful is nice, it's just hard to get used to after them being totally useless for so long. It's kind of weird that, you know... wait, do I even need crystal plorts? I don't think I do. No. It was really weird for them to be the mascot character, yet they're basically garbage slimes. Because they were so... the plorts are so cheap. I mean, they're still cheap. Got some nice radiation in there. Hmm. Unfortunately, I think I still have like 18 billion plorts to sell to get that last frickin'... with only 1,200 more, I guess, but it's still a lot. Have you grown yet? Oh, you have! Don't let me surprised. I was about to go to sleep just to let this crap grow. Pink plorts being useful is nice because it lets you, you know, pink plorts will eat, or pink slimes will eat anything, so you can combine them with fussy eaters, like, anything that needs meat, and then suddenly it's a lot easier to feed. But you still have to feed it its favorite food to double, so I usually combine something that eats a vegetable or a fruit, in order to, deal with that, so do I have... I do have mangoes in here. Oka Oka, I think, is in here. Yeah, I like the lamp. I'm just gonna put beets in here. I'm just gonna grow up some more food before doing anything else. I don't really like mystery onions, or the odd onions, whatever they're called. That kind of reminds me of Dot Hack, which is a plus, but otherwise they just end up with tons of trash carrots. And I have a surprising amount of them. Let's feed these trash carrots to the new slimes. Kind of surprised the frame rate isn't worse in here. It's not good, but it could definitely be a lot worse than it is. Alright. Give me the pink plorts. I have no pink plorts. Yeah, my current status is basically just that I need 18 billion pink plorts to continue grinding crap. I also need a bunch of treasure pods, and I don't know, are there treasure pod maps out yet? I should double check this. That wasn't the last time I looked. Oh hey, the BeamBot works now in Discord. That's nice. Everyone's watching on YouTube today though, but on Beam, it should be able to let you join my Discord from Beam and all that stuff. Treasure pod. Currently we have listed 12 green treasure pods. Just below the right entrance to the volcanic cave. Let me see. Let me compare my notes to this. See if I'm missing anything. Blue coral columns. I'm pretty sure I have that. Blue coral columns. Minty grass patch. Mossy tree stump. That's new. Dang, that one's a complicated one. Gives you a blueprint of decorations. What do you mean? That's not... Excuse you? Ugh, amber slime lamp, got that. Wildflower patch, got that. Mossy tree. Don't have the mossy tree. Hello. Tooties fan? Violet Depot? What do you mean Violet Depot? I'm not sure some of these are accurate. Sponge shrub. Violet slime lamp. Sponge tree. Coral grass patch. I don't think I have that. Alright, so let's find that coral grass patch. To the left of the Tabby Gordo near the bridge, the moss. Wait, what? I definitely have... Oh, I do have the coral grass patch. Never mind, I'm stupid. I mean Violet Depot to the right of the Pink Gordo across the gap and through the cave. The largest forest section is near a water fountain surrounded by a stone ring, and the pod can be found behind it. Spot is only... Okay. Alright, so we're gonna hunt for some treasure pods, I guess. I think I know where to get this one, this mossy tree one. Moss blanket below a wall of wooden platforms. I think I've already gotten that one. Do you mean that turret thing? I think that was one of the first things unlocked. I haven't made it yet. But I have it. Right, I'm going to the moss blankets this way. I'm trying to find all the treasure pods first. I don't have the blue treasure pod thing, and there's apparently a ton of, like, more of those than I thought. It says there's 9. Alright, so... oh, where is it? Wait, what? Why didn't that work? I thought you were supposed to shoot it with stuff and it gives you things! I don't understand those stupid things at all. I thought you were supposed to shoot stuff at them and they gave you money. I don't understand. Whatever. I really don't like those things or the gold slimes. They're super rare and you always panic when you see them and then they're gone in like 5 seconds. They're just dumb. And you have to have a ton of crap in your gun to shoot out at them, which you might not have, and whatever, it's just dumb. Alright, so behind a... oh, right, these should have stuff on me, right? Huh? Oh. Get rid of those. Bee noises. Ugh. They give you so few things! I gotta say, these things are a little bit frustrating. It takes a fair amount of stuff to make them, and then they give you, like, almost nothing. Alright, so it's in here, I think, near us. Near a water spring? The instructions aren't really good. And the largest forest section of the Moss Blanket is near a water fountain surrounded by a stone ring. Wait. What is that? Oh. Did I already get this one? No, I can't have already gotten this one. Oh, you feed it a chicken? Oh. Did they change that? Or am I... oh, I think I'm thinking of the gold ones. But again, that's not much better because I didn't have a chicken. Oh well. I don't really need a great deal more money anyway. Ah, come on. It's in the large forest section near a water fountain surrounded by stone tree. Behind the tree to the fountain's left. Mossy tree. Is there a water spring in here? Yeah, there is. I think I've seen one. Ah, come on. How's it? Maybe over this way? A stone ring. This is not surrounded by a stone ring, so it's not that one, I think. These instructions are really not particularly great, I must say. So, I guess it's not that. Mountain surrounded by a stone ring. Oh, they only give you 75 coins. Oh, hello, hunter slimes. Oh, they spawn more than once now. Only 2, but still. The hunter slimes have been kind of annoying because they're really rare. And so I can't really make my zoo out of them. How do you get over there? This thing just says the large forest section of the moss blanket. near a waterfront. Like, that's the entire moss blanket. That's like everything. I have this one, which I can't even get open. Hey, you gamer. Yeah, I think I only really care about the gold slime one because that gives me an achievement that I don't have. And I'm close enough that I might as well get the last of the achievements. So is it here or... Oh, that's a fountain. My feral bloom slimes. I don't think that's it. I don't know, I don't see any treasure pods. Wait. Is that the treasure pod? The one that I have opened? I could swear I already opened that. Like, I could swear it was a thing I don't have though. Slimepedia Ranch, Slime Science. That doesn't... Crap, I can't double check out in the field. Well, crap. Let's just confirm if this... No, this doesn't have... I don't see the stone ring they're talking about. Can't be in here. I really don't know what this thing is talking about. And this is like the only one that I can 100% confirm is a thing that I don't have. Mossy tree. Oh, whatever. What's one of these other ones? A blue coral column, mossy tree stump. After the hollow log that leads to the last section of the moss blanket. Oh gosh dang it, I just left. Aw, that was a dumb. I did a dumb. I'm sorry. I'm just gonna go to sleep and get some more crops. Oh. Oh wait, hold on, I gotta deposit all this crap. That's another thing, you just one of those extractors is enough to totally fill your inventory. I kinda wish the harvested stuff just went directly into your inventory or whatever. I guess I'll shove these guys with those. Yeah, it'd be nice if the sub areas had a name, or maybe a map, or maybe like a little check mark. Like, this would be a lot easier if just, like, there's a little check mark that says, like, oh hey, you got all of the green treasure pods in the dry reef, but you got blue treasure pods, you know? So I could, like, at least stop looking in a certain area. But the instructions aren't really helping either. Yeah, the farming stuff, or the mining stuff, kind of a pain, because you have to drag all of it back. Alright, so let's confirm that I know I don't have the mossy tree stump, right? No mossy tree stump. Amber slime lamp I do have. I figured there would be slime lamps of every color, but maybe they're just higher level things, so I can't open them yet. Mossy tree. Yeah, I just have a sponge tree, so I want the... Sponge is only accessible using a jetpack. Near a water fountain surrounded by a stone ring. I really don't know where they're going on with that, but I'll get the mossy tree stump anyway. That'll be easy enough. Hopefully after this next one, I'll unlock the next level of treasure tracker, because that's... Or the treasure cracker, because that's getting pretty frustrating that I don't have that. Also, I can't wait to put out some teleporters. I think I got one or two of the strange diamond things. Not really sure. With just a couple, though, not sure where they'd be most useful. Ah! Of course, there's another one I can't open. I think I know where most of the blue ones are, I just can't open them. So... Back through here. You know, I don't like swimming, but I love the sound of the water. It's very nice. In Animal Crossing New Leaf, if you make a home right by the beach or a waterfall, you actually get to hear, you know, the sound of the waves or whatever inside your home. It's actually a really neat touch. Alright, so what you got for me? Oh, those aren't ready yet. Whatever. I guess I should pick up some explosive plorts while I'm here. Because those have value now. Excuse you. Oh, and the pink! Right, the pink ones too. Ah, whatever. So, I don't think it's this section that's referring to. Could it be... Did that pink Gordo, or did that gray Gordo or whatever lead to a teleporter? Maybe it's behind a teleporter. I forget what was up here. There's definitely... Aw, come on. Jetpack, don't do me like this. Yeah, was there a teleporter here? Or no, I guess it just gave you a key. Ugh. Exploring all of this stuff wouldn't be quite so annoying if I hadn't already gone through all of this place, like, once. And now I'm, like, being told that everything I know is a lie. Sort of an awkward aspect of the early access experience. Congratulations, that thing you just did, it's meaningless. Go do it again! I think there's a different way to go through here, isn't there? Yeah, it's gonna leave the TARS. I wonder if you build water cannons in areas like this, if it really does keep the TARS down, because it's kind of frustrating that this area is always just eaten alive by TAR. And it's really not something you can deal with, honestly. You're just gonna have to leave them be. Let nature take its course. Hey, Boom Slimes. Are you surrounded by stone? No, this is the other one. I already saw this one. Alright, so... After the hollow log that leads to the last section of the moss blanket, there's a small opening to the right that leads to a bridge. What? A small opening to the right that leads to a bridge? I guess you mean this? I mean the jetpack and energy upgrade. But where are the hunter ferals? There's a ton of them. What? What hunter ferals? Is this somewhere new, like at the very edge? But where are the hunter ferals? There's tons of them. I don't know what it's talking about. I think we saw hunter ferals in a different section somewhere else. I think it was up there. How do I get to it, though? Okay, so it's not here, obviously. Ugh. This would be a lot easier with the map. I know vaguely what it's talking about. Oh! That is not to the right. That is to the left. That... Oh. Idiots. It says there's this bridge to the right. It is exactly to the left. Whatever. Oh! Alright. Need a jetpack, beware the hunter fails as a tunnel. Look for a small hollowed log. The smallest you've seen can still be entered. Fly straight up and look near the center of this area for a ledge holding the pod. Okay, so I think it's up this thing? It's a wiki, so fortunately I can correct that, but not at this moment. So it's up here somewhere? It's a ledge. Fly straight up and look near the center of this area for a ledge holding the pod. What do you mean, ledge? I don't see any ledge with the pod. Here? So glad this game has a jetpack. Makes some of this getting around a lot less annoying, so... I think the center must be more forward than I was estimating. Unless that was not the way to go, I don't know. Maybe it's here? Oh, here it is! Mossy tree stump. Please tell me that'll unlock the second level of treasure cracker, because I... Wait, so maybe this area is... Maybe I should look for that stupid fountain here, too. Ugh. Ow. Why do they, like, explode at you? Like, I assume they're supposed to be trying to bite you, but it just seems like they're just exploding all over you. Alright. Come on, energy. It would have been more specific if it meant this, as far as the fountain one, so I don't think it's here. There is a black treasure capsule here that I can't open. I think it's right past there. Uh-oh. Oops. Yeah. Okay. I'm just gonna go home and sleep and hope that my more advanced treasure tracker is open. Or cracker. I keep calling it treasure tracker because of that Toad game. I think that's about all we can do here. Hey, Budget Haddock. So... Violet Depot. What the heck? Top of Ring Island. Top of Ring Island. Ring Island. Oh, thanks for just leading me to a link that goes nowhere. What do you mean, Ring Island? Oh, for Pete's sake. It leads to a link that does not contain... It links to a page that doesn't have the information that you're supposed to know. Oh, whatever. Oh, thanks for the follow. Sorry, I'm kind of over here trying to figure out this... Rather poor instructions to all of this stuff. The explosion is explained in the feral slime entry. Oh. Oh, it's a feral slime thing, not a... Oh, okay. Is that new? I thought they just bit you before. Feral slimes allow you with a mean streak that'll attack. Seriously. Stomp them with their butts? Oh, it's a butt stamp. It's explosive butt stomp? The most dangerous kind. Alright, so it's gotta be somewhere here in the moss blanket. I just don't know what it means by stone circle. I don't think I've seen one with a stone circle around it. It's gotta mean this area when it says the large forest, right? Cause like this is the largest, like, single area in the game. Wait, there's a thing. Let's go there. And it's in a stone circle! Okay, I think I found it. Where is it, though? It's around one of the trees. Okay. I'm sorry, Wiki. You're not as inaccurate as I thought. So, moss blanket. Go behind the tree to the fountain's left. What do you mean, to the fountain's left? The fountain doesn't have a left. Is it up here or something? I don't understand. Where... Behind the behind the tree. Oh, here we go. There we go. Aussie tree. Alright, so... Ring Island, to the right of the pink Gordo, across the gap of the cave. Ledge with the pink grass. I think there's only one treasure cracker left to get, so let's go back home. Can we get bees yet? Oh. Give me the bees. Or the honey. Oh, for Pete's sake, I have to give up all my things. See, just one of these things, if it gives you the right stuff, can fill your entire inventory. It's kind of frustrating. But whatever. I think if we go back here, we can go up. I think I have the stuff to make a water turret. I'm not sure where I'd use it. I guess I may as well try to put it out here or something, because I don't really get tars in my ranch. Alright. Is this a quick teleport back to the ranch? I think it is. I lose my bearings after, like, not playing this game between updates. Alright, back at the ranch. I don't even know what I made that corral for. Should probably clean that up and put something else here. I hope they give you something that lets you run even longer, because it doesn't feel like very long. Alright, let's deposit all of this crap. Buzz wax, toxicome. Now what do you need for a hydro turret? Deep brine, puddle plort, spiral steam. I don't have to deconstruct it to move it, do I? I guess I'll find out. Target tar and blast out the water. Well, let's go somewhere that actually will have tar first. I guess we'll make one last lap to the frickin' moss blanket, because I can't think of anywhere else that really regularly gets tar. Oh hey, give me your plorts. That'll be useful. I'll take that. Give me a phosphor plort. Oh, come on. Oh, there's phosphor plorts. Oh no, that's just a phosphor slime. Oh, whatever. I'll just take the slime. Oh wait. I can make one right here. Alright, let's put down the turret. Can I pick it up? Oh, you can! Sweet! Okay. Phosphor. Rock. Eat the rock plort. And now eat the pink plort. Oh wait, it's still installing. Hold on. Don't go evil yet. Do you have to install them? I guess that makes sense. Oh, there's already tar. Aw, it takes 2 minutes to install? Aw, come on. Oh, whatever. Hi, tar. How you doing? Oh, dang. I didn't need to help make tar at all, did I? Oh, it's the thing! It's the thing! Oh, crap. I gotta hit it with stuff. Aw, it's gone. I hate these things! It was there for 2 seconds! Oh, those gold things freaking suck. Are you done installing yet? I do hope that they find some way to make fighting the tar a bit more fun. Because especially if you don't have water on hand, they're just really annoying. Excuse me? Well, I like that you can see the LED things that make up these little things when you get close. It's a neat touch. Oh my gosh. I can't believe they take so long to build. Excuse you. Yeah, I know you can hit them with anything, but I didn't really have anything to hit it with. I usually keep my inventory empty, you know, so I can pick up stuff. I guess I should just keep some garbage with me. Because it is one of the last few achievements I need. Alright, are we... Is it installed? Man, it looks so wimpy. Excuse you! Did it die, I guess? Eat it and become a tar. There you go. I guess that qualifies as effective. Let's get a few more to breed first, though. I guess against just a couple tar, it's quite effective. I like that you can pick it up and, like, take it around. I was worried that would be one of those ones you have to deconstruct. It's a bit slow. Not very smart. Let's bring you out in the open. Come here. Not very impressive range. Well, I'll consider that a successful test, I guess. Alright, now I need to build a bunch more crap. Wait, where was this Ring Island thing? Pink Gordo. Wasn't the Pink Gordo here? On that island? Let's see here. On the top of Ring Island, to the right of the Pink Gordo, across the gap and through the cave, the pond is on the ledge with pink grass. What is Ring Island? Pink Phosphor Feral Spawn. Dry reef. Pink Gordo. No? The wiki has like just enough information to almost help me, but also very much confuse me. Does anyone know what this Ring Island to the right of the Pink Gordo across the gap and through the cave means? Pond is on the ledge of the pink grass. I can't really make heads or tails of that. This isn't Ring Island, is it? I think I searched here. I don't think there's a cave around here. Wait, whoa, what's down there? I don't know there's a thing down here. Just a water spring? Weird. I didn't know this was down here. I guess you can't inhale the slime sea for water. Is that the one that was in a cave? Ring Island. It wasn't there There's a cave around here, but I think that I found the treasure cracker in it already. Yeah. I don't know what it means by Violet Depot either. Yeah, I don't know what that thing's talking about. Could it be that island I teleported to last time? There's a bunch of, like, crystal slimes and explosive slimes, and there was a lot of rings around it, I guess. You get there via teleporter via the Tappy Gordo. Oh, was that the teleporter here? Is that this thing? Is this Ring Island? On top of Ring Island to the right of the Pink Gordo across the gap through the cave. Is this the right sort of area? I mean, it's an island. There's a couple rings on it. I don't see Sonic, but... yeah, see, there's little stone rings and stuff. Maybe this is it. How do I get up? Around this way, yeah. Oh. That was a little dangerous. I think there was a Pink Gordo here. So yeah, maybe it is up here. Though I explored this place like 2 times last episode. I'll be sad face if I missed something. Unfortunately, I don't remember where the Pink Gordo was, and I'm sure I've fed it by now. Was it just right here? Urf. Uh-oh. No jetpack. Maybe it's on, like, the very, very tippy top of the island. I don't know, not very- oh! Yep, this must be it! Violet Warp Depot. Oh. They really missed- why would you put Violet and not Warp Depot? Like, the warping is, like, the critical aspect there, in my opinion. I guess there is. Is there another warp depot? But still. Like, I had no idea what a violet depot is. Oh well. I'm just gonna leave these poor slimes to their doom. How do I leave here? Hey, buddy. Hey, puddle slime. It'd be really nice if these sub-areas had official names that, like, appeared when you teleported to them. I had no idea this was quote-unquote Ring Island, and I've been here, like, 3 times. Oop. No. Calm down, teleport. Uh-oh. Okay, keep doing that. Do different colors really matter? I don't know. It might just be a cosmetic thing. It's only the second. So I think I've opened every green treasure pod. So when I sleep, I must get the next one, right? I've been pretty confused about that. But that would make sense. Hopefully I should be able to make a crap ton of extractors. Don't really need these auto onions though. Hmm. like that this stupid thing has physics. All things should have physics. Alright, let's get some pink plorts. I've only dropped 1% of frames, so yeah, I have a sneaking suspicion that just streaming at nighttime is a problem, which is really annoying. But, I might just have to stream a bit earlier than usual. How's the game audio, by the way? I've been having some audio issues. Oka Oka, that's for red slimes, yeah. Gotta get rid of all those small slimes. Depends on how you mean really dickish. I mean, a couple of those were pretty weird, but I don't think this is the sort of game that would be like, oh, you have to walk across, you know, an invisible bridge while holding, you know, both L and R, and, you know, hold the Wiimote sideways and etc. Okay, I think I might have a few too many slimes here. Okay, perhaps, yes. Perhaps 50 slimes in one cage is slightly excessive. Perhaps. Oh well, I don't really care right now. The colors are so you can make multiple links. Oh, you can only have one teleporter of each color? Oh, that is less cool than I was expecting then. That is kind of annoying. That's not what I meant to do. Don't make plorts. No, don't make plorts. That's bad. Come here. Ah, no. Get in the sea. There you go. Where's that food? Food is dangerous. No! Stop eating things! Ah, jerk. Is a little bit dangerous. I just gotta put all these extra ones in the sea. I'm thinking about 25 is about right. 25 Largos of certain types seems to be okay. The rad honey slimes, I managed to pack an incredible amount of those in, but they seem a lot more chill than certain other types of slime. The explosives, you can have even less. That was just super annoying. Get out of there. I put a rock in with the rads? I didn't put any in. Ah, oh, come on. In the sea. In the sea. I don't think I put any back in their cage, did I? I don't see any rock ones in there. Oh. Oh, I'm stupid. Hold on. Come here. Your gift is death. Thank you for noticing that. There you go. Can you do anything to prevent getting irradiated? Not really. It's not really a big deal, though. You only start taking damage after that meter fills to 100. Which, even with a lot of them, you'll at least, you know, be aware of it before you start taking damage. Oh, come on, Bill. Why isn't that thing back alive yet? Don't you have a music thing? Why are you so fussy? Did I forget the music thing? No, I didn't. I don't know why these guys are being such jerks, but they get to go into the sea. Things. You guys can have carrots, because you guys haven't been escaping. Come here. Come here. Ugh, the frame rates. Come here. Come here, little ones. It's time to die. See, even if you get fully irradiated, it really doesn't matter too much. Come here. Oh, you go in the sea. Slime population control is very important. Oh! Rude. Nope. Yeah, the rock ones seem a lot better at escaping. I should just keep less rock ones. Pay for your sins. Alright, so I think, oh come on! Why are those ones so freaking aggressive at escaping? You can splash them with water to get rid of the aura for 2 seconds? Oh, I didn't know that. I don't really mess with water. I always run out of water real fast. Oh dang! That is very effective, holy crap. They look so happy! Except for the starving one, but oops. No, you stay in your cage. I knew you could do that with the crystal stuff. I guess water is the kind of all-around calm the heck down thing. Oh yeah, a restaurant I used to go to, or not restaurant, a grocery store used to have lobsters, and I would always watch the lobsters when I was a kid. I had a big old tank of fresh lobsters. Would you calm yourselves? Oka Oka, that's for you jerks, isn't it? Somehow way less pink slime or pink plorts than I was expecting to have by now. Hey, webbed man. Yes, it's slime science, the best kind of science. Alright. I really hope they start working on performance for lots of slimes, because this update gives me a lot of reason to have a great ton of slimes all in one place that produce plorts as well. Alright, so I think we have about all the pink plorts we're going to get for today. How many things can I make? Advanced drill. I really hate that it goes down. Alright, let's see what else we... Wait, do I have to buy those, or... No, I don't. Hey, Dodo. Violet Warp Depot. So you can only use one of each color of Warp Depot or something? Whoa, lava dust? I don't have lava dust yet. That's annoying. Oh, I don't have enough deep brine either. Dang, I gotta... Some of this stuff is really hungry for materials. I have like a billion jellystone, and I don't have anything to do with it. What's the reason for having loads of slimes? Because you need, look at the requirements here. So, I need a ton of spiral steam, and to make a ton of spiral steam, I need to make a ton of these advanced pumps. So that means 20 pink plorts each, 12 tabby plorts, 6 boom plorts, which I'm already out of boom plorts. Apiary. Ah, oh, jeez. Okay, so what I really need, I need boom. I think I need pink boom slimes in place of these crystal ones. Oh, and that's gonna be freaking annoying as heck. What do? Minerals craft stuff. I do have a corral full of slime, of explosive slimes. Ugh, does this mean I have to incinerate yet another set of slimes? Why did I even put these crystals? I guess I just assumed I would need crystal slimes. I'm sorry, crystal slimes. You're the coolest, but I really don't need you right now. You can almost feel the frame rates improving immediately. They want to be with their friends, which is actually really problematic because they turn into evil monsters if they see their friends. I'm really glad the crystal things can't, like, break the walls or anything. Get in there. Hey, whoa, how did that one... Oh, you are extra dead. You are extra freaking dead. Get in there. Come here. Come here. Hey, Esky. No, you're not late. I was kind of randomly... This is kind of a random stream. I was gonna play Slime Rancher anyway. And, I've been meaning to test what my internet... Yeah, you know, whether I have my streaming problems earlier in the day, which it seems like I don't. Oh, come on. Okay, I'm gonna try just... Actually, with the boom ones, I better be really... I'm gonna try, like, 15 boom ones. Because those ones are really annoying to deal with. I think the Largos fly around a bit less. Uh-oh. You're a tar. How did you become a tar? That's... Oh, there's Plorts. Yeah, you're getting dead, my friend. Ugh. You know what? I'm gonna kill a few more of you, too. Just for security's sake. And a couple of you. Just because it's easier with an incinerator around. Okay. You know what's funny is the ones that can fly are the ones that are giving me the least grief right now. You can lid the enclosures, but they break the lids. Like, you can see the lid on this one, but it breaks after a few hits. So these ones over here keep breaking theirs. Like, it's currently on, but if they keep hitting it, like, it's red, and now it's gone. It helps, but it does not permanently keep them in there. If this is your first time seeing Slime Rancher, I've got a bunch of other videos. Like, it got me doing a 5-day challenge, which sort of gives you the basics of how to play and stuff. Frick, the explosive ones, their favorite food is... I had to plan this out wrong. So the explosive ones' favorite food is meat, which is really annoying. So I usually pair the explosive ones with something that eats a vegetable. But then again, doubling them up isn't really a big thing. Oh, you don't know what the slime science update is? Oh, for Pete's sake, I hate these things. Yeah, they added a bunch of stuff. Oh, dang, I'm like dead. Hold on. I didn't even notice that. Hmm. I probably didn't plan this very well, did I? You get lava dust with advanced drill. Yeah, I think I just haven't found it yet. Like, I've been placing those there. There's, like, never a safe moment to go in there, is there? Ow! Okay. Okay, I'm just gonna chill out for a bit. Hmm. I guess if I put honey booms, I think honey booms would be my best idea here. Corral, high wall, music box, air net, plort, feeder. I don't know if spraying them calms them down. Doesn't seem like it. I unfortunately think my honey ones are in here. I think I may have gotten a few too many rad slimes. Just maybe. You know, maybe. It's a possibility. Okay, that should be 15. I bet they're what's causing the lag in here. I should probably get rid of some of those. But whatever. Yeah, honey booms. The honey slimes seem pretty chill, so maybe honey booms be less annoying. Are you out of the cage? Yeah, you get into the sea. Are you also out? Oh, come on. Yeah, I put way too many. I'm gonna try just 15. In this one. I was definitely overeager with the other cages. This freaking thing! I always get stuck on it. Okay, you think you're clever? Think you're clever? This is kind of why I had stopped making big corrals with lots of slimes for a while. But now I need them again. Nah, these are the most updated frickin' things I can get, unfortunately. I do wish there was a third, even more taller option for the cages, but there's not. Delay is ridiculous. If the delay is bugging you, you should watch on Beam. The delay is less than 5 seconds for Beam. Just go to beam.pro/sirtaptap. I'll toss the link in the thing. But yeah, the delays on YouTube is pretty long, but I can't really do anything about it. Yeah, just go watch on Beam. It's really easy to sign up and stuff. Or you can just watch without signing up. It's pretty nice. Ah! This game has the stickiest geometry I've ever seen. So I think those jerks need food. So it's the mint mango, which sounds disgusting, is the favorite food of those ones, isn't it? I would not eat a mint mango, I must say. That sounds highly unpleasant. Some flavors are just not meant to mix. I got lots of this crap, don't I? Yeah, boom slimes are probably my least favorite in terms of just being freaking annoying. And not just because of the explosions, but mostly because they freaking escape and they need meat to eat. But their largos don't. Yeah, Beam's newer and like, I'm not gonna stream only on Beam because, you know, most people are elsewhere, but it's been a lot nicer. Like the delay is a lot lower. It's got a more modern interface. I think they're all largos now. That was fast. You freaking jerks and your escape fetishes. Get in the sea, my friend. I put way too many in here. There you go. Yeah, the honey slimes in general are really cute. The honey rats are my favorite. They toned down the explosions, so they're less annoying now. How did you... Oh, I thought I cleaned out enough of you. Yeah, Beam does have some bugs and stuff to fix. But, overall, it's probably my favorite streaming platform. YouTube's still kind of my home, but, I can stream to all three major things anyway. It kind of feels like what Hitbox always kind of wanted to be, but Hitbox never really... I don't know. It really never feels like Hitbox capitalized on, you know, Twitch's problems. Excuse you. Alright, can I build more pumps now? Alright, I'm still missing Tabby. That's not a big deal. Oh, I'm low on pink plorts of all things. You need so freaking many pink plorts! Oh well, we're good for now. I shouldn't leave food on the floor. Food on the floor is very dangerous outside of corrals. Freaking tars. I've never had a tar outbreak since I learned, like, the basics of the game, but we did have- we had one tar back there. I wouldn't really call that an outbreak, though. I don't know why these don't give timers anymore. They used to give a timer for how much longer you had until it expired. Odd onion and the carrots. I think mango's here. Alright, now we're gonna sleep, and I better freaking get that next treasure cracker. I'll be very irate if I don't. There we go. Treasure Cracker Mark II. There we go. Okay. 9,000! Holy crap! I have enough for that, but geez, that's like the most expensive item in the game. Yeah, the slime plush is really cute. I hope they make some slime plushes when, like, the game's not even out yet, so I'm not surprised they don't have them yet, but it'd be cool when the game is fully released. Alright, so mint mango, I definitely need those. Heartbeat. Oops. No. Getting in the thing. I like how these are little faces. They're little happy faces. They want you to shoot things into them. Rad slimes. Oh, rad slimes have been here for months. I guess I haven't played for a while. Aw, did you escape again? No, rad slimes were in the update that launched when I first got the game. Yeah, that was like 3 or like 0.3 or something, which was a while ago. We're already up to 0.4. Yeah, they've added rad slimes, hunter slimes, crystal slimes, and they added all of the slime science stuff is new. I guess those things need cube berries, don't they? Ugh, this herd needs so much thinning. I regret everything. I know how college goes. I don't entirely miss it. People were nice, but the the more important aspects, less so. It is kind of nice to just be proper farming again, though. That's one thing. I kind of ran out of reasons to actually farm in the original, or in the pre-science update, Slime Rancher. Get in the sea, my tiny friend. Do they have an estimate on when the game will be early access? I don't know. There's still quite a bit of stuff planned. So that's enough farming for now. Now I can make some more apiaries. And now I need to go distribute all of this crap and look for more treasure. So, hold on. Blue treasure cracker. Oh dang, there's 6 black ones. I thought there was only 3. Coral arch near the pink first. Alright, wait. We can get to the Indigo Quarry real quick, can't we? I really like these teleporters connecting a few of the areas together. So all of the drills go here. I don't know where these slimes come from. They're just kind of always here. Feels like they could take this game out of early access now. I mean, polish-wise, it's quite good, but it's still missing stuff. You do, well, until the slime science update, you kind of hit a wall once you got all of the slimes and explored all the areas. It's still missing the glass desert, which should be a pretty major area. Where does this teleporter take you to? Oh, right. I guess that's useful. Alright, so on a coral arch, dry reef, it leads to the Indigo Quarry, slime gate. Oh, right, I remember that one. Right after the big mushroom section in Moss Blanket, you find a wooden bridge to traverse through the pocket found the corner. Spring pad? Holy crap, this is a spring pad! I need that! Alright, what am I doing here? Oh, right. Gotta place the apiaries. Apiary. Where's the third place? Here we go. I guess Parker is super cute. Aw, oh, you freaking jerks! And your goonus. Big mushroom section of the moss blanket, we find wooden bridges to traverse to the pod we found in the corner here. Okay, I know where this one is. Big mushrooms. Oh, it doesn't ring a bell. I'm not sure that big mushroom. I think that's the new area with the feral slime. Which was that to the left or was that an earlier branch? So one of them is underwater here. Hmm. There we are. Particle fog doesn't work as well underwater, does it? Amber Warp Depot. So can you only set up one color of each color of depot? It's a little limited if so. What is that? Can you get there? I don't think I can hover that far. How do you get to that? No, I really don't think I can hover that far. Oh, hello. Where did the hunter slime come from? Oh, whatever. I think they must have added more hunter spawn points. I used to only be able to find literally one hunter in the entire game. Per day. Wait, I think the exit's... The moss blanket always turns me around, because they had an earlier moss blanket that was totally different. And now it's way bigger and better, but... Oh! You saw that! It was there for 2 seconds! You have to hit that 3 times to get an achievement. That is such crap. Alright, so I think the big mushroom section is this way. No, that's the... I know it's referring to, but oh, I think it's through here. Yeah, it's through here. Alright. Where if the big mushroom wood bridge is... in the corner. Wait, right after the big mushroom we find wood bridge to traverse through. Hey, Jonathan. Oh, I think it's... Maybe it's over here? Ah, here we go. I think that's all in the moss blanket. Yeah, the last section of the moth blanket for the one temple. I've got that one. Grotto. Grotto's teleporter. And the teleporter to the Indigo Core and the ranch. Find a pillar in the Rad Gordo's cave in the Indigo Core. It gives you a blueprint of a green teleporter. Alright, so now I just need to go back. Kind of tempted to just fall in the pit and die. I think that would actually be the fastest way. Oh, wait. Maybe the exit's near. No, it's not. Oh wait, yeah, the exit's just right here. Coral Arch Island. Oh, I think I know where that one is. Oh, the volcanic island, that's the one I was thinking of from before. In the last section of the moss blanket, no, I found that. Little islands with crosses. Go to the teleporter to the Indigo Quarry and the ranch. Wait. That's here. There's a ramp leading to a series of islands. What? Some of the stuff they added is totally new. Oh! Is this... what is this? I don't think this was here before. I guess it's this way. Half the reason I'm having trouble finding the treasure pods is because some of them are in areas that did not actually exist. Whoa. Startled me. Before. Yeah. Yeah, I don't remember this place being here at all. The heck? Danger? Oh, hey! Here's the thingy. Spring pad! Bounce pad! Love those bounce pads! Etc. Etc. This is new. Rock tabby feral slimes. Huh. Alright, now how do I get out of here? Wait, where does this go? Wait, is this where I came in? I don't think it is. Or is it? What? Now where am I? I don't think this is a place. I think this is just random geometry. Oh! What the hell? Where am I? Okay. I have no idea where I am. Huh. Oh, oh, wow. Okay, so a lot of stuff loops back to other places. There's a lot less dead ends now, which is neat. I think I found one right around here, really easily accessible, but it was a blue one, so I couldn't open it. Just pass here, I think? Yeah, there it is. That spring pad sounds awesome, though. I hope I can make it. Pink coral columns. Boring, but whatever. I hope you don't have to deconstruct the decorations to move them elsewhere. Otherwise, if you do, I probably won't even bother making them. You can't make cosmetic stuff too much effort, in my opinion. Unless it's like, you know, character customization, sure, because that's pretty vital. Or pretty important to people. Is it on here, maybe? Ah, there it is. Hey, Aniel. Yeah, I really love the look of this game. It, looks very nice. Violet teleporter? I guess it's just violet, pink, and amber for some reason for all of the different things. Alright, so coral arch. First section of dry reef. Leads to slightly a high area. Pogo fruit. Pink coral column. Spring pad. Right at the big mushroom. Glow cones. Volcanic carry. Okay, I think everything else is in the indigo quarry. So, I think we can reach the ranch. This might be a stretch. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Now we're good, I think. Seems like a safe place to hang out. Alrighty. So, I also love the little gold sparkles in the sand when the light hits it just right. Nice stuff. I don't know why I still have this tower. I don't know what to do with this part of the ranch. It's not orderly enough to put corrals down in. Maybe I should move my little puddle slimes in there. Also, it's nice that puddle plorts, they're a lot more useful now because they, you can make those hydro cannons with them. Suck up all the foods. I'm wondering if I sleep. No, I probably need to get all of the freaking things to get the third level of the treasure cracker. Why do I have a pink slime? Get out of here. So if I stream earlier, it's very quiet, but it doesn't have any of the frickin' frame drop issues. I might have to stream, I might try streaming like maybe at 2 p.m. I don't know, it's a bit late for the Euros. Maybe if I, noon kind of feels weird, like weirdly early for US streaming, but it would be right about the right time for Europe, I think. Come here, come here, come here. You're gonna die. They don't actually die if they go in the slime sea, but still more cathartic that way. So yeah, 15 of these things seems entirely maintainable, surprisingly. Alright, let's see if we can make anything fun. Spring pad! Heck yeah. Oh, it's not too expensive. Hunter plorts. Aw, oh, it needs lots of tabby plorts, though. Wild honey. I'm really not sure when I would ever need a med station. Like, maybe I could plant a few randomly out in the fields, but... Pink teleporter, violet teleporter. Oh, I need spiral steam for that. I guess I need lava dust for all of those, don't I? You need pink plorts for almost all of this crap, too! I'm really happy on the pink plorts. So there's gotta be a pink slime lamp, considering all of the other colorations, isn't there? I'm gonna sleep just in case it decides to give me the last level with the treasure cracker, because that would be a nice surprise. If not, I guess I have to run through the indigo quarry. Ah, come on. Guess not. Alright, so... Indigo Quarry. Last section must be somewhere high in the volcanic cave. Ooh, a crystal cluster! That sounds like a fun decoration. I'm not sure why I put all of these in different... Well, I know why I put those in different areas, but... what a very safe... cage to be in. Oh, oh, oh! There's so many I can barely even extinguish all of it. It still has a nice glow to it. Ah, that's the stuff. Safe, totally non-lethal radiation. Alright, let's get back to... Indigo Quarry. Oh, do you have some stuff for me? No, you don't, not yet. So... I think the crystal cave was out... off! Out here. Oh. No, not that one. It's out on one of these. I think it might be the high up one. try this one. No, I think this is the entrance area, isn't it? Yeah. I think it's the high up one that I need to go through. Alright, so... up here. Come on. Waiting for energy is probably my least favorite part of this game at this point. There we go. Oh. Wait, this isn't where I thought it is either. What'd you miss? I don't know how long. There's that island again! How do you get there? That's just back to the ranch. I don't need that. Find a pillar in Rad's Gordo's cave, gives you a blueprint of the green teleporter. For now, I'm just looking for the last few treasure pods, which should all be an Indigo Quarry. See, it's definitely not here. I want to say the Rad Gordo's cave is somewhere around here. These areas still kind of all look the same to me. Oh, here's one! Green slime lamp! Okay, so green is also a color for those thingies. I think that's all the places we can go from here. At the bottom of the wooden plank, Seraphil cleft Rad. Oh, so that is near the Rad Gordo's cave. In the pond section of the Indigo Quarry. Where is the Rad Gordo's cave then? Oh, right, here it is, here it is, here it is. There's a bunch of these all crammed together real close. There's another one. Green teleporter. Oh, so all the green stuff is in the Indigo Quarry, huh? And I think I know where the other two are. Alright, so back to the middle cave. Which I think is in here. And these are probably, these probably have stuff for me, don't they? Yep. And it's all junk, but whatever. Still a bit of skipping. You might want to put the transcoder on 480p if you're getting frame drops and stuff. I've only dropped 1% of frames, so it shouldn't really be very stuttery. Stream itself. I think that's all. It's dropped it. Wait, I guess I don't really need to stop. I just need to get two more things. There we go. Okay, so is it through this way? No, I think it's the other way. It's the one with the pond plort, or the pond slimes. Puddle slimes, I think they are. Oh yeah, yeah, it's up this way. Ah, so close. Hey, Mr. Rosen. So, I think we just go up here a bit. So in the volcanic cave, there's a found, you find a just somewhere in the volcanic cave. I think I saw it before though. it's all that hidden. I'm gonna get some crystal slimes while I'm here. Oh dang, there's like huge... Wait, is that a pink or a explosive? I don't tell with these pink slimes here too. Pink slimes are kind of the worst because they cause almost all of the tar infestations. There's very few tar infestations that happen for any reason other than pink slimes. Crystal cluster. So that should be a pretty decoration to put around. So, last one is over here. And I believe this will be all of the treasure, the blue treasure pods. At least that's, they're listed on the wiki for now. It's 12 green ones, 9 blue ones, and 6 black ones, which sounds about right. They just hid this little Gordo back here. So glad I found this one so I knew what they were talking about. Alright, so behind a pillar in the Rad's Gordo's cave and the Indigo Quarry. Wait, no, that's the Rad Gordo, the bottom of the wood planks. Center crater hole on Volcanic Island, okay. I mean, this island's really pretty. It's a shame I didn't really have any use for it when I first found it. I couldn't open the frickin' treasure that was in here. I really love the crystals from the, crystal slimes. I'm stuck. There we go. There we go. Fire flower patch. Alright, I think that's all of it. Now I just have to go back home. Ugh. Well, that was much easier than just randomly groping around. Let's get some water while I'm out here. It's so weird there's no way to get water on the frickin' ranch. Like, even with the Slime Science update, I don't think there's any way to get water on the ranch other than an empty, you'd have to make an empty puddle thing. I guess maybe that's the intent, is to make a puddle. But, or a pond, whatever they call that. The thing we keep the puddle slimes. Ah, geometry, please. I get stuck on so much geometry. Box quote, stickiest geometry, IGN. Shove you lads in there. They're so cute! They're a nice shade of indigo, too. Even if they are kind of, you know, rock slime clones, they're still great. Oops. So much freaking jellystone, I don't think I'll ever use all of it. Frame rates, please. Why aren't those ports being sucked up? Oh well. I'm just gonna sleep now so I can get my last treasure cracker. And then I should be able to get all of the frickin' the black ones. So I guess at least from this display, they plan to add 5 more slimes. On Twitter, they were mentioning something about some slime that, like, they weren't even sure if they're gonna be able to implement. Wait. Did I not put down the pumps? I did not put down the pumps. Oops. Do I have to put these pumps out here? Or does a pump in here fine too? I don't know. I'm just gonna be safe and put them out here. Anyway, it is sleepy times. I can't believe I didn't know that before now. It's kind of fun. You know. Just calm down the radiation with a little water, it's fine. Some weird glitchiness like you would see on TV. I'm not sure what you mean. Do you mean on these displays? I do like how these display things work. Oh, and thanks to the follow, Bloom Ninja. So, I'm pretty sure I've unlocked that last treasure cracker, so I'm gonna suck up all of this stuff and go back to bed. It's so much easier when you only need a couple of different fruits to feed everything with. The automatic feeder feels kind of pointless, because you can just throw all of it in there, and it'll just get eaten eventually. And, like, the automatic feeder isn't, like, smart enough to, like, make it really, like, noticeably different. Oh, wait, I am streaming. I think I'm still streaming lower bitrate. Oh, frick. I didn't even notice that. Ugh, I hate this whole streaming issue so much. I've been streaming at half the bitrate I usually mean to. Because that's what I had to do to get it to not skip constantly last time. I just upped my bitrate to double what it was before. And hopefully, since I'm not streaming at peak hours, I shouldn't have any frame issues. Oh. Completely full up on plorts. That was fast. Fortunately, I don't really have too much need for money, so I don't really have to worry too much about over-adding plorts to the foundry, because you can't get plorts back out. You've seen the Scare-Tar thing, the real tar. Yeah, hopefully the stream should look better now, because the bitrate's way higher. This game kind of needs pretty solid bitrate to look quite right, but should be alright. Now, it doesn't seem like I'm dropping frames, so yeah, I think I found a decent... Well, not decent, but I think I found something that works. Is that a tar? How is there a tar in here? What the? How did you get? I blame you jerks. What happened here? Oh, it must have been these plorts that fell out. But how did somebody escape? Oh man, I hope they didn't kill one of those things. Alright, who escaped? Show what happened there. I guess I should throw a couple water cannons in here. Is, well, I already have one that I don't really have any other use for. It's gonna be hard to have a good location. Ah, this freaking, that one pillar. That one pillar. Sure, put a hydro turret there. Kinda sucks that you, like, can't, well, not that you can't, but there's no point in putting the extractors on your farm, even though you have the most space to put them on your farm. Because you won't get the rarest items from the farm. I'm just gonna sell this patch. Oh. One too many. Get in there. I'm just gonna sell this patch because I still have that stupid plort achievement to get. I think I already had that from before, but in the beta stages, they there's a bug that erased achievement progress. But they're official Steam achievements now, so I don't really have that issue anymore. Alright, now let's sleep. Oh wait. Guess I'll suck these out. Now we will sleep, and hopefully get that last frickin' treasure cracker. Excuse me? Where is my last treasure cracker? I could swear I got all of the things, hold on. I'm gonna go... I'm almost certain I got all of these. But let's just check these out. You may just have to wait a few extra days. This would be less annoying if I hadn't already, you know, done everything. Hey, Sun Gaming. So, I found... Violet Teleporter. Pink Coral Columns. Spring Pad. Glow Cones. Got the Glow Cones. Oh, that's what those are called. Amber Warp. Wait. I have Amber Warp Depot. One way. Pods found underwater. I'm pretty sure that's the Amber Warp Depot they're saying, not the Amber Warp. Anyway, Fire Flower Patch. Got that one. Fire Flower Patch. Green Slime Lamp. Yeah, I got that. Green Teleporter. Indigo Quarry. Ugh, this is the one they didn't mark, but I got that one. Oh, you've missed way more than 37 minutes of a stream. But yeah, I haven't been having issues, so... And yeah, I upped the bitrate to 25, you know, 2.5 megabits, so... I think it must just be peak hours that are the problem, and that's really annoying, and I'm gonna talk to my ISP again, since I confirmed that's the issue. But, alright, so the Amber Teleporter is a black... It's a level 3, so I have everything that I could have here. I can almost make the slime ball hoop. I just need more tabby plorts, oddly enough. I think I have more than enough honey ones. Hey, Have you tried transcoding on Beam? Like, watch the 480p stream on Beam. Oops. I guess I can just give you all of these. I have heard Beam, people do seem to have a bit more trouble streaming, like receiving the stream on Beam. Streaming terminology is such a mess because people use the same words or a lot of different words to refer to either the same thing or a lot of different things, and it's always very confusing. You were on 480? Huh. Yeah, I do kind of wish they had something extra to deal with the explosive slimes. Visually, I like them, but they're such a pain in the butt. How many more do I freaking need to sell? Ugh, 1,000. Which isn't really as much as it sounds like, considering how many easily I can get another 100, but still annoying. You're on their Flash player, or their HTML5 player, right? I think it defaults to that. Yeah, Beam does have a few technical issues. They received a ton of money from, they got acquired by Microsoft, so hopefully their general quality should be improving quite a lot fairly soon. They did fix their Discord connection, so if you wanted to join my Discord and didn't like get a link or anything, you can just go on Beam and you can find there's a link to join it from there. You have to follow, but that shouldn't be a problem, assuming you want to be in my Discord. Hey, Radioactive. Mint Mango. Used to be a smoke machine that I could use on beehives. Yeah, there is the music machine. It seems like the music machine should make them, like, explode less, but it doesn't really... I don't even know if the music machine does anything, because they still seem pretty agitated. Honestly, considering the production these guys have, it really doesn't seem like you need more than 15 slimes in a pen in terms of plort production. As long as you feed them your their favorite food. It seems more critical than anything. Oh, how did you- Oh, I hate these things. Get in the sea. No, get- there you go. You did it, champ. I'm so glad they never starve, because feeding all of them is actually a really monumental task, unless you have very few slimes. I was gonna sleep until I get that frickin' thing that I want. It's kind of annoying that that's how progress is achieved. Allegedly? Why am I not getting that treasure cracker? Yeah, I think it's supposed to make them jump around less, but it doesn't seem very significant at all. I think I'm still missing one. It's the volcanic dust that I'm missing. Which I don't know why I've not got that yet. Can I make those depot things yet? I assume I can just like teleport crap like almost directly in here. Um, I really want a spring pad just for funsies. But I should see if I can build anything more useful first. I can build some teleporters. Well, one teleporter. Pink warp depot. Ah, they all need lava dust. Whatever. I'll build the teleporters that I can make. Oh, dang, you can only make one. Okay. Not enough resources. Ah, come on. Ugh, whatever. Can I make the slime ball hoop yet? No? Ugh, white slimes can't jump. Though to play this game, but you have no money. Yeah, it's a really great game, but you'll have money sometime. The game will still be there, and it'll be better by the time you play it, because, you know, early access and all that. It's been really improving quite a lot. Like, this is you. Oh, get out of here. It's been one of the better examples I've seen of early access, because it has both that feel of, like, you know, it doesn't feel early access, yet at the same time, it's added quite a ton since the first time I played. It does have a few things that you kind of notice. Like, you know, performance isn't super amazing, but it definitely works. And there's some areas that are missing. Up in the volcano area? I thought it was just the quarry, not the actual. I mean, I could try that now that I have a teleporter. I wouldn't think though. I do have a teleporter now though, so I can start testing a bit more exotic locations. Because it won't be very hard to return. Oh, thanks for the follow. Alright, let's put. So it's mostly dust I need now, right? I need 3 lava dusts. So, build tons of... Oh, wait. Lava dust is from the drills, right? Sure. Lava dust. Lava dust. Oh, come on. The Google search for that is completely useless. Okay, I found a Steam discussion forum. Just a rare drop from pumps? Wait. Drills and such that a ranch will give you generic items, not the area specific. Dust. P.S. Lava dust. Where can I find lava dust? I got a crazy ton of brine, but getting lava dust takes forever. If you put the pump around your ranch, it gets you... Using the apiary of the moss blanket because you have honey, royal jelly. Okay, so the lava dust is from a pump, which does not make sense. I mean, that is the shape of the things that pumps drop, so I was kind of suspicious. But I guess I need to make more pumps. Which unfortunately means I'm going to need a lot more freaking tabby plorts. Do not have. I guess I can put one more pen here. High walls. Music. Plort. Airnet. Feeder. Alright. Oops. Where did I put chat? There's chat. Hi, chat. So, I need tabby plorts, but I need something to combine the tabbies with to make them more productive. I've already got... I guess I should have done phosphor tabbies. Because I'm not even using the phosphor ones that I have. So yeah, let's make phosphor tabbies, I guess. Phosphor ones are the easiest to get more of, so let's mostly get phosphor. Alright, 15... Nah... Eh, 15 seems plenty. Oops. There's a hunter slime in there. There you go, friend. How many pumps did I get? Also, it sounds like it's a rare drop from anywhere, so I might just put it in the ranch. I don't know. I don't know if I need the other... I don't know how much deep brine I need. Alright, so now... Sheesh, I get so much from these guys. Oh! Excuse you! Well, that's where I got... Do you want to get TARS? Because that's how you get TARS. Oh, speak of the devil. Ah, oh, son of a bitch. You know what? You can just eat all of those, actually. Ah, oh, what? No! Not this menu! You know what? Fine. I didn't like those slimes anyway. And now they're dead. Whatever. You guys get to die. Guess what? This is your eternal reward. Oh, no. I don't know what was up with that pen, but I hate them. And so now they get to all die. I think I just put too many freaking in, but I kept thinning the herd and they kept getting out. Whatever. Jerks. This is two more tar invasions than I've ever had since figuring out what makes tars. Do you need solar shield? Oh crap, you're right. Oh, please don't be dead. Yeah, they're dead. Sorry, phosphor slimes. I got so used to not needing those. Here you go, friend. It's okay. Phosphor slimes are really easy to replace. Is it facing the wall? Oh, whatever, it probably doesn't matter. Alright, and now I probably need to grow a bunch of these. I really wish the remove crops button was not, like, immediately next to the demolish thing, because I've done that many times. Alright, I keep forgetting about my slime lamp. This is really neat. I figured you could just put any old slime in those, which would make for a much wider variety of lamp colors, but, oh well. Heartbeats. Those go in here. Alright. Now let's put some more pumps down. Now where the heck do I want to put this teleporter? Because I finally got a teleporter. And I guess to where the tabby slime spawn would be one area that's of interest. I don't know where where else I would want to put one. The Tabby Slimes and the Crystal Slimes are some of the more annoying ones to find. Oh, you jerks. I should probably put these guys a little bit away from the other ones because of the flying plort issue. I wonder if a plort just happened to, like, somehow phase through the wall. I think we've got enough explosive plorts for quite a while. Like, let's see what our count is. I see you, James. Ah, the geometry, please. Shove these in here. I hope they eventually have, like, a thing where you can have up to 100 items. Because I end up switching stuff a lot. I think the basic one was, like, 20, and they upgraded it, but, still doesn't feel like a ton. Unfortunately, you can only sleep till morning. You can't, like, instantly make it night in any way. Kinda need phosphorus slimes. Boom slimes cause plorts to glitch through walls. Do they still do that? I thought they'd... Some of the patch notes said that they had improved the behavior of the explosive slimes, but they still seem pretty annoying. I really think they should just add some sort of feature or have the music player subdue the boom slimes even more than they already are. So they're still pretty disruptive, without real benefit to justify it. Like, I'm required to have some at this point, but... See, these guys never escaped! These guys, unlike those freaking pink ones, I think the honey just makes them more chill. I never have problems with the honey ones. Alright, guess I gotta sleep and wait for some more. So they made it less likely to happen? Oh. Not less enough. Oh, what am I doing? I can't carry any. Arg. Heartbeats. Oh, I'm starting to drop some frames. Not nearly as many as before, but 4% is still not great. Oh, it's still none of the freaking stuff. Also, is there nothing better than these advanced ones? I was hoping there'd be like a third level of things that like farm even more. Still no lava dust. dang, I don't even have enough Fluster Slimes left over. Crap. Level 3, it lasts forever this time. That would be a very welcome change. Tabby plorts for that crap, so violet teleporter. Oh, I can make a violet teleporter now. Might as well. Ugh, why does it reset? Still zero lava dust. Guess I may as well sell some honey. Delicious honey plort cereal! In stores now! I wonder if it was an explosion while I was sucking in a plort, and then it just flew out. You'd think there'd be some logic that just, it's impossible for a plort to leave a pen or something. Ugh, now I need nighttime for those stupid phosphor jerks. I guess I could just sacrifice some of my tabby slimes. So I should probably be reading some more of the flavor text in this game. It's really good. I'm so proud of how well I got all of these, like, there's so many slimes in here, and yet they never freaking escape. It's so nice. I don't know why some of the other slimes could really take some inspiration from this starving mound here. They're just such troopers. Anyway, what am I doing? Oh. Farming some foods. Yeah, the rad slimes and honey slimes are both really chill. They're my favorite ones. Can I put more here yet? I think I got enough heartbeats for now. Crops. It's Q-berry season. Oh, wait, first I better harvest these. Should have enough mint mangoes and such for now. I just really want to make all of those teleporters that I can. And then, I don't know what the deal is with the treasure thing. I have all of the treasure that's known, so I don't know what could possibly be stopping me from the next level of stuff. I guess I have too many mint mangoes. Too many of these two. And I'll just sacrifice some of my tabbies. I can find more. Guess I already have a pretty good amount. So if you shoot a slime, a plort directly into a slime, they automatically, like, transform, but I guess if you shoot a slime into a plort, it doesn't work quite the same. Have a food. you still hungry? Everyone teleport now. Oh, that one's still hungry. Have a food. I really like that if you specifically shoot a thing, you know, a plort or a food, they will automatically eat it. As long as it collides. It's very helpful for really crowded pens. Now eat it! There you go. Almost made a liar out of me. Alright, I think they're all Largos now. Alright, cool stuff. So much jellystone and nothing to use it on. I guess I still need one more strange diamond for the teleporters. Wait, what's... I wonder what the third... Slime science to open them, treasure cracker upgrade. Three of them. It doesn't tell you when you get the treasure cracker upgrades. So there's an amber teleporter. I think there's one more of each teleporter. Can I make the hoop yet? I need more tabby slime or tabby plorts. I'm back to low, having less frickin' pink slimes, though. Oh, there's no thing there. I think I'm just gonna sleep a lot and see if I can get that treasure cracker, because there's nothing else I can do. Didn't get it. I guess I have enough cube berries I can feed the pink ones too. Wait, did I not pull the plort collector? Oh, I did. Physics for the corrals work really well. You can shoot things in, but they will not come out. And it's aside from the explosive guys, it all works pretty well. Yeah, I'm back to dropping a sizable amount of frames. Ugh. I really hope Mediacom fixes their crap. So let's try just 2 megabits. Let's see if that drops less frames. So I have, dang, 25,000 dropped frames overall, but that's over 2.5 hours. So it's not as horrific as it sounds. Also, dang, I did not intend to stream quite this long. Hibernation Simulator 2016. That's what it's about to be. I was tempted to just sleep for 5 days, but that would kill all of my plants. Not that I can't remake them, but since I just planted them, I may as well grab some here. I think I have enough spare plants left in there. Oh, not as bad as I thought. I think I'm just gonna go to bread. Wait, did I check these? I also need 3 of those volcanic dust things. I guess 4. I think there's one more color. Give me all of your stuff. have too much crap. Up, they're dead. That's the stuff! I think. Oh no, that's just the oil. There's too many different items. If only I could build, you know, a teleporter. A warp station, if only I had the materials for that. Ha ha ha. Yeah, that thing is definitely facing the wall by default. That's so silly. Okay. God, I hope I find some stupid volcanic stuff. Yeah, that's just oil. I don't even know if I need oil. I think I might just place a bunch of them on my farm and hope that there being one less item means that I will get slightly higher chance of getting the thing. Yep, still none. Nothing. Wonderful. I get some little spiral steam. I found the diamonds a lot easier than I found these. Let's get those tabby plorts. There we go. That's what I'm talking about. Wait, you can rotate the gadgets? How do you rotate? Do you just have to pick it up and then place it again? I guess that works. Oops. Oops. Alright, can I make that jump ball now? The sports ball hoop? Aw, oh, you need spiral steam for that, you jerks! Aw, oh, you need steam for that too! Why is steam so rare? I guess we can make some of these, but I don't want to make those until I'm done making these things. Oh, I need honey for that. I guess I just need more pumps. Just gotta pump it up. Oh, go on, use the vac shoot buttons? Oh! Oh, that is super useful. Thank you for that. I had no idea. Not sure if I need any more phosphor plorts. I think I can just sell these. I kind of wish you could put like a shipping bin, like from Harvest Moon, in like, you know, here, so I could, you know. I guess it's not too big of a distance, but when you do it a ton of times, it does get on your nerves. Also, I meant to sell those phosphor plorts, but I guess it's not a big deal to put them in here. Arrgh. Hey, Potato Tower. Yeah, they had a live demonstration of the turret. Alright, let's... I guess the rotation of this guy doesn't matter. Though you can make him boogie. That is a plus. I forget what it was. Oh! I was gonna put a bunch of pumps on the farm, and hopefully if they're on the farm, they have a higher chance of getting the rare one. Did I already get the sweet, sweet rewards from these? No, yes I did. Right, teleporter. Did I make a teleport? I think I can, what, dang it? Sold permanently until demolished. Oh dang, it's a permanent, ah! Choices, I don't know. I don't know where I want to put my warp things. And it's one of those ones you can't remove without being destroyed. Oh, well, I'll think about it later. I just want to get the materials to make all the things first. Hey, Looper Loop. So I guess I can edit together a, a video for where to find all of the treasure things now that I think about it. Because I found all of the things on stream. What's this game about? Very much not about shooting stuff. It's, you find slimes and then you ranch them. Like this. This is a slime. He's not actively being ranched. I don't really have any reason to ranch him, but if I wish to, he could be very much ranched. But for right now, I'm just grinding for materials. Because they just added a bunch of stuff to let you do so. Still no strange diamonds. I think I only need one more. No, I need two more strange diamonds. Also, it's about to become Hibernation Simulator 2017. Because I think I need to sleep until I unlock a certain thing. Which is kind of an annoying unlock mechanism, isn't it? So, got those. Now I need the honey. Yeah, it's sort of like Pokemon catching. You go out in the field, and you can inhale small slimes with your backpack here, and then you bring them back to the farm, and you feed them. They drop little crystals, which you sell or use in construction. I do a better job of explaining it in my earlier videos, but it's generally how it goes. You're not ready. Oop. I'll take these. Ah! You get stuck on so much geometry in this. Oh! He was doing a sideways boogie there. I guess I can sell these plorts. The plorts are the crystals the slimes generate. And sell them for fun and profit. And here's my slime, my shy slimes. Have some more waters. I really don't know what to do with this field. If anybody has any ideas on what the heck I should do with this field, because it's like totally useless for now. I have all this extra space, but I don't know what to do with it. I could plant even more stuff, I guess? I guess I could put an extra little thing. You know what, for one thing, maybe one of the treasure pods is the name. Is the taming bell? That would be nice, but I don't think so. Because there's already an item to tame things. There's the music thing, which doesn't seem to work especially well. Wait, do I already have one of these in here? I was trying to have one of each slime, well, one of each Largo in here, but I kind of lost track. It's not really a very useful quest, anyway. Alright, I was gonna go to the... Oh no, these cue berries might get in the way. Just show those in there. I hate when games force me to make, like, a permanent or almost permanent decision, like... I guess you can make more teleporters eventually, but having to pick a permanent destination for a teleporter, frustrating. Should fill the whole area up with Largos and plant a ton of food so it's natural. The problem is that is I could only have one kind of Largo, because then I would get tar everywhere, and it would be a good place to have free-range slimes, but free-range slimes tend to just end up being tar. Give me your precious juices. Hexacomb. I think we needed that for one of the teleporty thingies. I needed that for something. I needed it anyway. I think six should be plenty. What are the antagonists? So slimes combine if they touch a crystal of a different slimes type. Like, you just see that's a pink and explosive one. But if they touch a third type of crystal, then they turn into tar slimes, which turn other slimes into more tar slimes. And basically kill all of your stuff. And they also eat, like, all of your food and stuff. It's generally a fairly passive, like, relaxing game. Not passive, but it's not too antagonistic, but the tar do present some danger. They're confirmed via Tumblr. There's an item named... Oh, there is a taming bell. I thought you were referring to the Pokemon Soothing Bell thing. The wiki does not list what is in the level 3 treasure pods. So that's... It's possible that's what's in them. But, it doesn't want to let me get the third level treasure thing. See you, Mr. Rosen. Also, it's kind of weird to me that there's honey, but there's also honey slimes, like... So there's bees and honey slimes, like, do bees and honey slimes fight, or... What's the interaction there? I think I could make something with that hexacomb, I forget what. See what we got. I guess I'm just making tons of pumps for now. Oh, I'm out of Tabby Plorts again. Oh, it was the teleporter, I think. Yeah, I just need freaking lava dust at this point. And one more strange thing, strange diamond. I'll worry about the decorations and curios later. It's so weird, they have full info on how to get to these things, but they don't have the blueprints of most of them. I guess that makes sense, because you can find them without opening them. Some guy got a shiny starter. Lots of people get shiny starter. A lot of people reset their game until they get a shiny starter. I don't recommend playing like that, because that's like... How many resets is that on average? Like, I think it's like over 1,000. It's many thousand. I've still never seen a native shiny. I've been given over 5 shinies from other people. I've never seen a real, like, not given to me shiny, aside from, you know, forced shinies. If you reload the game, I guess maybe. I'll try one more. Well, oh hey, that plant died. Here you go. I am kind of at a loss for what to do, so yeah, I think I'll close the game and get back in and then sleep and see if that helps. Oh, natures. I don't like natures or IVs in Pokemon, honestly. Let's do a little save and quit. Just be paranoid, I'll close the whole freaking game. Relaunch Slime Rancher. Come on, Slime Rancher. You can do it. You got this. You can do this. You can open a video game. There you go. It only shows up in Shiny in the status and in battle. Huh, that's weird. Oh, speaking of Sun Moon, is there any reason not to use those QR codes? Like, do you get your thing banned if you use the QR codes? Like, I heard people found a bunch of QR codes. And I kind of want to just get, if there's any legendaries or whatever, I kind of just want to get stuff and not worry about it. But I also don't want to get banned. But, like, apparently they're distributing a bunch of crap through QR codes this time, which doesn't, like... why not just use the download feature? I don't know. I haven't actually played too much of Sun Moon yet. I was gonna do that today, and then I ended up playing this for a lot. Alright, I was gonna sleep, which it's probably too late. I don't know. Nothing yet. They're doing their sideways boogie again. Calm down. Look at that boogie! Look at him go! Shake that booty! Oh, they're both doing it! Everybody's in on this! Oh, they stopped. They look kinda like the little UFOs. Oh! That's inappropriate, you two. Get a room! You guys can eat those. Oh, this is a single player game. It's all designed and, single player. Oh, I forgot to harvest you. No lava dust. Still. Where is the other freaking lava dust? Oh, I gotta wait a minute. I'm not that patient. You think I got a minute to wait? Ridiculous. Let's harvest all these Q-berries. I really like Q-berries, they're very cute. The challenging effects? Well, it's kind of like, you know, Harvest Moon and stuff. You gotta get money, you gotta find all of the plorts, or all the slimes. You know, you're looking at end game here. You're not looking at, you know, me braving the wilds or anything. I already did all that stuff long ago. Dump these things in. Like these Q-berries, you'd have to explore and find those out in the wild. Slime. It said it's just a random drop. It's like the strange diamond, where it's just a very rare drop. There we go. If you want to see, you know, videos of me playing earlier in the game, I have a bunch. I have 4 videos before this, 2 live streams, and like one is me doing the 5-day challenge, Which, if you want challenge, that's more how to go. But, you know, it's mostly just, you know, relaxing game. What gadget am I looking forward to right now? I mostly want the stupid depot things, which the game doesn't seem to want to give me. Because I need three of the lava dusts, or I need at least one to make one of them. I also want to make that hoop. I forget what I'm missing for that. So the thing is, I'm not even sure how the distribute thing works. I don't want to, like, waste... one of those stupidly rare things while getting it set up. Ah, they're not ready yet. Wait, people are using the QR codes to hack in Pokemon? Huh. That does seem like a silly way to, distribute. If you can just, you know, build a QR code and just have its stats be, you know... Do you just edit the QR code to edit stats and stuff? I figured they just had a bunch of preset QR codes and that people were exploiting those. Which, you know, I'm not sure how you would even... Like, I don't think you can even prevent that. Ugh! Give me the rare thing! Alright, I need a bunch of the spiral steam. I think everything I need so far is... these stupid pumps. I'm so tired of these pumps. Tired of their crap. Alright, here we go. One of you has to have... Oh, come on. Wait, so this does count. This does count as being part of the, all Pokemon in the LLR region have a QR code option to view. That's not like to scan, that's not like to import, right? King Slime. Actually, they do have Gordos where you have to open up new areas and teleporters, you need, there's these Gordo slimes that are big fat things. You gotta feed them 100 or 50 food, I think it is. To make him explode and either give you the key or open up a teleporter. Ah, geometry! Why? Wait, did one of those just escape? No, it's just my eyes playing tricks on me. If the developer is watching, please fix this stupid pillar to the left. I always get caught on it. Aside from that time, obviously. Alright, let's get some Tabby Plorts. I haven't even gotten to the most important part of Sun Moon yet, the part where you can take your hat off. You start off without your hat, and I was so happy, but then they make you put on your hat, and the professor even mocks you. They mock you by stating, oh, how you have to have a hat. It's like, no. I've worn a hat for 20 years. I don't want to wear a hat anymore. But I think you can be without a hat, because they showed a thing where the trainers did not have hats in the battle thingy. So I'm pretty sure there's the option to go hatless. Suspect is hatless. Repeat, hatless. Oh, right. I guess I gotta go check these things for diamonds, too. I don't know why it's not giving me this frickin' last treasure cracker. I have all of the known treasure. Either the wiki is missing something, or it's being really weird about giving me the treasure cracker. Aw, come on, I just need the diamonds. I have so much jellystone, I don't even know what I'm supposed to be able to do with it. It doesn't seem like you need much of it at all. On the plus side, I think I have all of the indigoium and stuff that I need. So I think I can just place these around the farm to make them a little bit easier to access. Can you place stuff in here? No. Overall, I do really like the update though, the gadget update. I don't like consumable stuff too much. So I do wish some stuff lasted longer or I didn't have to destroy it to move it. So. Only that stupid lava dust. Oh, I can make a slime ball hoop! Number one slime stage. Oh, that takes two of my royal jelly. I don't think I need royal jelly for anything else, do I? Oh, I've got so much oil and crap. Right, can I make even more pumps? I'm just gonna make more pumps. Enough bumps. Oops, forgot to dump these in here. Indigoium. Oh, you can trade Pokemon via QR codes? That's weird. Like I said, I haven't even finished the intro like cutscene thing. I was pretty tired last night, so I just kind of went to bed. We're in the middle of upgrade stuff at work, so it's been pretty stressful. But the game's mostly just like, it's half ranching, half like exploration and adventure stuff. I've just already done most of the exploration. I do have to go back and find all the treasure capsules, though. Which I can't do until the game decides to give me the third level of the treasure cracker, because I already got everything else. Alright, let me place all these stupid things. Wait, what? Pump limits! You only get 6 pumps? Okay. That's new info. I guess I just gotta sleep until the game either decides to give me the item I need or the unlock that I need. Okay, so you're ready. I'm just gonna build these next ones closer to the frickin' farm. Oh, come on! Give me the stuffs! Can you only build one stage and one slime ball hoop? It's a QR scanner, let's see. That sounds like you can check the information, not that you can, like, trade it, though. Which is what I would expect, because, I mean, you can give anybody that QR code. Slime ball hoop. Oh, I don't have enough tabby plorts. Oh, I don't have... I need the slime ball hoop. The slime ball hoop is important. Scanning in, you can register your Pokemon to find out where they live. Scan it. Check its habitat. Oh. That's kind of neat, I guess. But I mean, I know where most things would. Well, I guess not in this Pokemon game, but. There we go! Wait, can you only make one, or. Oh, you can make more than one. I don't need more than one, but. Well, I hope you don't have to permanently. Alright, let's get a bunch of pink slimes and play some slime ball. Yes, come here, my pretties. Yes, come to me. Slime, darkness, come unto me! Give me all of the slimes. Oh yeah, so it's like having seen them in your Pokédex. So that, yeah, that's cool. Alright, so please tell me the Slime Ball Hoop is not one of those ones that I can't, that is permanent. I think that means it's not permanent, if it doesn't mark it. Oh, let's get some stuff. Oh wait, I don't have, get out of my inventory. Ah, no! Sake. I'm never gonna find this stupid lava dust. I hate it. Oh well. Slime ball hoop. Ah. This music. Ah, no, come down a little bit. I just realized my farm is gonna be a total mess. This was... I probably should have put this somewhere else, outside of my farm. There we go. Yeah, this was probably unwise. But also amazing. It's slime ball, you gotta... Sometimes you gotta... You gotta break a few eggs to play some slime ball, you know? No. I just want 40. I want 40. No! The dramatic music really makes it. Okay, let's get these stupid slimes out of my farm. Okay, don't play slime ball on your farm. Play it somewhere else. Unfortunately, these slimes will stay persistent if you don't get rid of them. Anything on your farm is persistent. Well, not items on the floor, but their items on the floor last quite a while, but not forever. This was not one of my better ideas, I must admit. See you, Balloon Ninja. Ah, we're dropping frames again? I guess it's just an isolated thing, but yeah, we're... Ugh. I really hate my frickin' internet service provider. I can't get anything better. I wish they would bring frickin' fiber. Frickin' our internet infrastructure is frickin' pathetic. Okay, lesson learned. Should just be four more slimes. They want to go meet their friends, which is annoying because meeting their friends makes TARS. Alright, where's the last one? Where is he? Oh, there he is. Alright, let's not do that again. Yeah, that Super Mario Rabbids thing does not sound particularly legit to me. Oops. Thank you. I think I'm just gonna sleep. I'm gonna let these pumps run out, and if I don't get the stuff, I'll still have the pump. If I don't either get my treasure cracker or the thingy, the lava dust, I'm gonna stop for now, because I already been streaming for quite some time. Ugh, 1 minute. Annoying. Oh, these ones are ready. Garbage. Oh, for Pete's sake, the rare items do seem a tiny bit too rare. Oh, come on. Did I already, yeah. Alright, so now I think I can place more of these. The rumor metamorphosized into a Fire Emblem thing? I can see a Mario slash Fire Emblem RPG, but actually not really. Not with breeding, not with like weird human eugenics Fire Emblem. I can see that with like older Fire Emblem. I don't know, you breed Mario and Peach to get like Rosalina. Like, that's everyone's fetish right there. That's like DeviantArt, the video game. I'm not sure Nintendo is prepared to create that. Whatever. I just need, like, 3 units. I guess 4 units total. And it's taken me this long and I've gotten none. I'll be happy if I could just get one, but... Arg. Mario RPG crossover with Rabbids and it plays like Fire Emblem. Does Ubisoft still do stuff with Nintendo? Like, crossover stuff? Did they ever do any kind of crossover stuff? I don't know. I can see them maybe doing it, like, to mend ties or some dumb crap, but I don't know. It doesn't sound like something I would be interested in. But they've already been like, no, we have one Mario RPG, so we can never again have any Mario RPGs. That was their excuse for gutting poor Paper Mario and sending it to an early grave. Wait, am I offline on Twitch? Or is Twitch just being stupid? Oh my gosh, why did these players take so long to open a stream? Oh no, it's fine. I should just trust the stupid thing that... The thing that Restreamio... Excuse me. Yeah, I really don't think we're gonna be getting that treasure cracker. But I really don't get this treasure cracker business. Yeah, I've heard that Color Splash is okay, but it still doesn't really interest me at all. You gotta be kidding me. This is so dumb. Like, Color Splash seems like the sort of thing that would be fine on its own, but like, why is it not what it should be? Why is it not just, you know, another proper Paper Mario RPG? Why didn't they just make a new series to do this stuff with, you know? I'm not too excited about it, you know, continuing a trend, because I mean, it's already continuing a trend. It's sticker star, but less suck. And like, that's okay, I guess, if you like sticker star, which nobody did. It's just hard to be excited about that at all. Okay, I'm giving this until these pods all die. Why won't you give me the frickin' treasure cracker? What is your deal? Oh, you mean getting closer to RPG? I get, but I mean, it's very clearly, like, they've explicitly stated it's intentionally not RPG-like. So I don't know. Wow, it's really not gonna give me any. Oh my gosh, finally! Frickin' finally! That it took that many for one lava dust. Oh my gosh. Do we have more pumps? No, I ran out of pumps. Ugh. I have so much primordial oil. Alright. So I can make one thing, and I bet it's one of those things that I have to permanently install. So I'm not even gonna wanna make one immediately. Make a nice purple one. Not enough resource. What do you? Oh, I have to put it in first. All right, so we finally have our precious lava dust, and we can make one out of the three things that's available. Let's make purple one, I guess. And let me guess, it's a permanent install. Yep, it's a permanent one. Ogh. Two gadgets, remote transfer resources. Argh. I'm not ready for responsibilities, it's too early for that. I'm gonna sleep one last time to see if I get the stupid treasure cracker. Because now let me double check, but I think I have I've grabbed all of the items in the game again. Resources, I think there's one fruit and one berry, or one fruit and one thing that don't exist yet. Yeah, so I've touched all of the, I've obtained one of each, you know, mineral and stuff. So if that was the unlock condition, we should be good. Okay, I have no idea what the stupid unlock condition is. Maybe it's random, maybe it's an exceedingly long number of days, who knows. But yeah, it's been a long stream, so I'm gonna stop streaming for now. I gotta do some other stuff, and we'll be streaming Kirby's Dream Land 3 at 6 p.m. Central. I'm not sure what time it is now. I guess that's in 4 hours. So yeah, look forward to that if you like Kirby or whatever. But yeah, thanks for watching, everybody. And if anybody knows what the deal is with this stupid treasure cracker, send me a comment or a tweet or whatever, because I really do want to get that last one. But the game doesn't seem to want to let me do so. I don't know.